You treat it like a job. An unpleasant job to be gotten through as fast as possible. Kissing is forbidden. This makes it bearable. One detaches oneself. One describes. An act of copulation, fertilization, perhaps. No more to you than a bee is to a flower. You steel yourself. You pretend not to be present. Not in the flesh. You leave your body.
You girls will serve the leaders and their barren wives. You will bear children for them.
Generation of 4D ultrasound scans has opened up a window on the womb, allowing us to see the development of the fetus as never before.
Baby night.
You.
And a couple of my nails were ragged, and it was kind of fun in a necrophile sort of way.
I dreamed someone was raping me. I dreamed it was someone inhuman.
Thanks a lot.
Get off the baby's heartbeat!
No! No! No!
Will you die for him?
Yes, I will. I will die for him. I will die for him.
Embryo looks more like a tiny human and becomes known as a fetus.
Time to welcome my other half. All giving, all knowing, whose sole purpose is to keep me alive. Inseparable, the two of us until birth. When the one without the soul will not survive.
You die for him. You die for him!
You've got this force of nature now inside you. Baby knows what to do. Baby will tell you what to do. It's just nature's way.
I think nature's a bit of an arse, though, don't you?
You're getting better at this.
Now, as far as, oh, wait, someone can actually take that away from us, it's a brand new concept to a lot of women.
And I think one of the things that's happened to them is rights were won for them long ago, and they just took them for granted. Their interests were other. And then suddenly, bang, a light bulb goes on. Maybe somebody's going to take these rights away.
In cities around the world, handmaids have been taking to the streets, heads down in silent subordination, their scarlet cloaks and oversized bonnets, an unlikely symbol of feminist anger.
En el que cada individuo es libre de tomar decisiones concernientes a la salud y el cuerpo de ella o él, o en uno en el que la mitad de la población es libre y la otra mitad es esclavizada.